Michael Chandler versus Dan Hooker, UFC 257. That's the fight that should have been made several months ago. Not the Tony Ferguson fight, not the Dustin Poirier fight, certainly not a title fight. Michael Chandler needs to walk in here and he needs to prove himself against a tough guy like Dan Hooker. And I saw some fans being like, oh, this is not what Michael Chandler signed up for. He signed up for big fights. Excuse me, Michael Chandler wasn't even the Bellator champion. With all due respect, he wasn't. So it's not like he should be getting a unification belt.
Don't you talk about the Nature Boy. The Nature Boy. It was like when the Nature Boy showed up to WWE and they put him in the Royal Rumble and
He
put the
didn't
belt
have the
on.
belt though.
Didn't have it. No, yeah, he did. He
No,
stole it.
no. Rick
He
had the
had
belt.
it. Rick had the
Michael
belt.
doesn't. Michael doesn't have the belt. So he shouldn't be fighting the champion. Dan Hooker's the perfect guy. In fact, when he signed, go back several months in writing, ESPN.com, I said he should fight Paul Felder or Dan Hooker. Those were the fights, and they got it right. So that's the co-main event. I love it. What about you?
Great fight. Listen, I remember one time I was doing a promo for the pay-per-view, right? And it was Conor and Dustin sitting up top, and I was trying to build some of the other fights. And I was like, oh, it said a fight will be added.
Oh, yes.
I'm sitting there knowing, I'm sitting there knowing that it's gonna be Chandler versus someone, right? But can't say it. But the excitement inside of me was like, oh my goodness, like people are going to love this matchup. It's a great matchup.
Wait, but didn't you think it was Gaethje when you said that?
Dan Hooker, Ariel, what I tell you is not always,
Oh, you were working me. Because I feel like
sometimes
you
I
said
have to
Gaethje.
work.
All right.
Sometimes I have to work you at times, like you work me, you work me. Matter of
Never.
fact, we don't even talk. We don't even talk anymore when we're not doing the show because
That's
we don't
such a
want things to
lie.
get in
That's
the
such
way
a
of the
lie.
show.
It's like
But
four missed
anyways,
calls, and then I finally get you on text if I'm lucky.
and anyways, listen, excuse me. Anyways, excuse me. Perfect fight.
That's
Dan
funny.
Hooker is going to challenge and make Michael Chandler fight in every aspect of mixed martial arts. Hooker is as tough as they come. He's from a great team. He's got unbelievable fighting spirit, will, cardio. I mean, him and Dustin Poirier went to absolute war in the Apex just recently. And if you want to see whether or not Michael Chandler's ready for the elite of the division, he has to fight and beat Dan Hooker, which is not an easy thing to do. Challenging fight. I'm not exactly sure. I mean, I can say it. I can say it. Outside of Patricio Pitbull, is it Patricio Pitbull?
Patricio.
Patricio Pitbull. Outside of Patricio Pitbull, who I think is fantastic, this will be the toughest fight he's ever had. I mean, he's never seen anybody
Oh,
like.
Eddie Alvarez. Don't forget about Eddie Alvarez, the two
Yeah,
fights.
but, and those fights are great. But I don't know, man.
Come on, man. Eddie
This
Alvarez in
Dan.
his prime, Eddie
Oh,
Alvarez.
no, you're right. Eddie Alvarez.
10
Pitbull
years
and
ago.
Alvarez, those are the two. I don't think he's ever seen anybody like that. So
Benson.
your first, not at this point with Benson, right? Like Benson isn't the same guy, right? So like when you look at who Dan Hooker is today in his absolute prime, coming off of his main event fight with Dustin Poirier, well, they went tit for tat over 25 minutes. This is one of, I mean, easily one of the biggest fights Chandler's ever been involved in. He also gets the rub. He gets to fight Khan on the same night as
Yes.
McGregor. It really will elevate Chandler if he can get the job done. But if he doesn't, we're back in a situation where you have those high thought of free agents that come to the UFC and it just doesn't work out.
Well, he has the perfect spot because if he wins and wins impressively, and then the next man up is Connor fighting, and let's say, just for the sake of this story, Connor wins. All the fans that are watching, because we know the numbers are going to be great, are going to be like, if he gets on the mic and says, "Hey, Conor McGregor, I want you," he aligns himself perfectly. Like
Hey,
that co-main spot is prime real estate, and
it's
he
not even
got
the co-main. It's like there are a number. Hey, I know this is my guy now is one of the biggest stars in the world, Habib. But do you remember UFC 205? I
Yep.
want to fight your chicken. Habib fought. Was he even on the main card at the time, or was he the prelim?
Prelim, Michael Johnson.
Right, Michael Johnson. Habib's on the prelims. I want to fight your chicken. And then all of a sudden, they start to mention Habib and Conor in the same breath, right? Habib isn't the champ yet. He's a young guy on his way up. And then it just builds. And then the UFC can call back to that, right? The Irish people going crazy with Habib in the middle of the octagon. And then if they ever come a time when they have to fight, there's just so much history built up. And I think that it just explodes. So for Chandler to be in the co-main event, it puts him in a perfect spot. And Dan Hooker, too. If I'm Dan Hooker and I win, I'm immediately saying something about McGregor. Whoever wins at 155 pounds on that fight card, you say something about McGregor, because guess what? McGregor doesn't have the ability to not respond. He will say something back because he gets going and he just kind of says something. He'll say something and elevate you. So, bro, I'm telling you, there's a level of stardom that comes with fighting on and with this dude that I've never seen. I mean, look at what happened after Khabib. I mean, Khabib went from what, 2 million followers to like 12 overnight. That's like, that's crazy. So yeah, I'm calling him out if I'm Michael Chandler, and I'm glad to be in that spot.
By the way, speaking of which, if they sold like a pay-per-view version of Dana's meeting with Khabib in Abu Dhabi this coming week,
million buys. Hey, listen.
This thing has been hyped up more than anything.
Boy, they have done a great job of building a meeting between Dana and Khabib. If they stream it, $5, you know, like, yeah, we're not going to charge you $6.
I was saying $49.95 they would sell, like 500,000 of those. Are you kidding me?
I'm selling the meeting with Khabib if I'm Dana White, because the meeting with Khabib may be his biggest pay-per-view of all time, because people want to see what's going to happen with this dude. For me, it's so refreshing to see how much Khabib has grown in terms of the general public. I love it, man. I love the dude. I think he's a great guy. And the intrigue around him is just, it's fantastic.
You know, like, back in the day in wrestling, they'd have the contract signings in the middle of the ring. Like, you do something like that. They come, they sit in a room, they have their negotiation. And either at the end, Khabib has to decide if he stays retired or will fight one more time. I mean, could you imagine the ratings? The ratings would be through the roof. What an idea that is.
It would be fantastic. Sadly, it won't be like that. I mean, we could let that dream go.
Sure. They might put me on conference just so I can take notes and report
back.
Yeah,
sure. You'd be the guy that they would call.
I think so.
To listen in on the meeting. Absolutely.